Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create a cutout brick wall. It's a realistic brick wall in Revit. Okay, today is quite interesting because normally when we start rendering or using our brick wall in our Revit, we are using for texture and some more. If we want for those kind of cutout brick wall, we need to go to our Photoshop and add in our image, then only we cut out those, then achieve our cutout brick wall. But today I'm going to show you how to create a realistic brick wall by using our existing family. Okay, so now as you can see on my screen here, we got some few photo reference before we jumping into our project. Okay, so now before I getting started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out to my channel or visiting to my channel and you want to learn more about Revit, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for notifications so you won't miss my future tutorial. Okay, so now I think it's pretty much. Let's switch into our project together. I'm going to give you a quick instruction to create that. Stick around together from start to finish. Okay, alright guys, as you can see, I am in Revit Architecture Template. It's an Ultra Revit 2021 student version. What I'm going to do first, I'm going to create some reference line first, and by create that, I need to create LI for 2D line because later on, easier for me to adjust my mask form, LI for shortcut key. Then I simply draw it up like this, make it about 6 meters. I think it's enough. Then hit escape a couple of times. Then I'm going to create another curve also, 6 meters or so. Then make here something like this. Hit escape a couple of times. Turn on for our 3D here. Then let me hide my elevation first. Then I want to change my graphic also, actually. Okay, it's perfect. It's time to create our mask. I'm going to our masking inside in plus mask and mask one. And of course, I got my 2D reference line. I just simply go to our reference and using our pick line is a faster way. Pick line, then go into pick here one and second, hit escape a couple of times and select my first pick line here. Create form, solid form. I need to unlock what? Because I need to adjust my height here, I need to unlock. Then I'm going to make it about, make it about 6 meter, hit escape. Let's make this one square and here also, create solid form. I need to unlock also, start from front here. Then I can draw it up. Okay, perfect. Then I can select my two panel here. Just hit a tab key until I got all of them. And make sure you hold control key when you select multiple selection. Device surface also. Then I can select my panel here. For you grill there, I'm going to change it for fixed distance and make it for 200 millimeter. And change it for fixed distance 420 millimeter. Hit apply. Okay. Then here again, fix this, then make it about 200, fix this, then make it for 420, hit apply. Okay, perfect. Now we got our form, we got device surface, and second step is we need to go to our file and create our family file, new family. Then I prefer using for metric 10 panel pattern best, just double click. Okay, now I read on pattern best for curtain panel. What I'm going to do next, I'm going to select my panel here because I need to adjust my panel size, same as our panel in our project. Simply make it about 420 as I remember, and here as I remember around 200, and hit apply. Then start from, let me open my level 1 first. Okay, perfect. Then let me create some reference plan first. I need to go to reference point for the center here. Like this, we could not use for. We need to delete first. Later on, you will know the reason. Here, as you can see, when I place on my previous, we can say our preview panel is adaptive. When I place here, my point here is can move up and move down. If you place here, will be some kind of normalized curve for control your length only. But here in my case here, I prefer using for place our point on top of our previous adaptive panel. Then I can move it away for more. I will move it on center here. Then of course I need to move here about 260 or so. Hit escape a couple of times and again go to reference. I'm going to place here again another guy here. Hit escape. Hit a tab key until I got my point here. Then we again for move, I can move it 260 and move it to center again. Okay, it's time to draw our brick wall reference rectangle. Make sure you work on work plan. Start rectangle until here and start another one from here until here. Hit escape a couple of times. Clone this one first. Go to our 3D and I can create our form here. Simply create form, solid form for extrusion. And okay, sorry, solid form again. We got two options, one is surface and another one is extrusion, but in our case we prefer using our extrusion and our thickness is 80, it's enough. Hit escape a couple of times. Let's load into our project. Then I can go to my 3D again, simply select my brick wall here and then no pattern, just change it to friendly one. And here again. Okay, when I zoom in closely, as you can see, it's quite fast and realistic for our brick wall with cut out. We don't need to use our Adobe Photoshop, but it's your choice, depend on what is the best way for you for working on how to you create your realistic brick wall. And of course here is not only for brick wall, is a parametric also. Let me select my brick wall first, then I can change my grid rotation 45 degree. And when I scrolling down here, okay, come on, I don't want like this. And 45 degree also, hit apply. As you can see, it's quite realistic for our brick wall. It's rotation 45 degree also. But when you finish up, sometimes you got some problem. You need to fix that and find the solution. Basically, you can using hidden element for fix that. Let me hit finish up first. See if you got some same problem. I will show you the solution. Just hit finish up first. Okay, I think we got some problem. It take time like this. Okay, as you can see, we got extra brick wall here is the exact problem. So how you saw that? I will tell you the quick way to saw that. Basically, you just select your brick wall here. Okay, hit a tab key, then hit a tab key again, then hit a tab key again. Hit a tab key again. Make sure you hold Ctrl key for multiple selection and right click on your cursor. Hide in view and just hide an element, it show it out. But when you find for quantity take us will be got some error a little bit for our brick wall when you start to order from supplier. But just my experience when I working as a QS is okay if we got some extra, because basically we will calculate about 10% for wastage for construction cost like our concrete or formwork, about something like those kind of construction work. I will mark up about 10% for wastage. This is the reason, so you don't need to worry about that. Okay, and then I'm going to select all here. I need to change something first before we finish our project. Okay, as you can see, and I turn on for shadow, and of course I need to hide element first. Come on, and this fall guy also. Make sure you hit attack key, then hold control key back. Right click. Okay, perfect. As you can see, we can create those curves also for our brick wall here. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. I hope it can help you out for create your realistic brick wall in Revit. And make sure hit subscribe button below. And this is your if this is your first time reaching out here, thank you for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice weekend. Thank you.